What's happening, people? It is Brian Alsruhe, NEVERsate.com, and I'm standing at the whiteboard, which means you are going to need something to write with because we are going to be talking programming. So I'm about ready to lay out the latest free program that I'm going to do for you guys. Now, this one is called Next Level Linear, and it's one that I've kind of been putting off writing for literally years. And to be honest, the reason why I've been putting off is because so many people got really good results from the free linear program that I put out a couple years ago, but then I've gotten literally thousands of emails of people saying, what's the next step? What should I move on to next? And I typically tell people, move on to rotating percentages now that you have a good idea where your PRs are. It's just gonna be better for you in the long run or whatever. However, people do not like to leave linear. For some people like myself, it's kind of nostalgic and romantic because if you run linear the way that I run it, you're working up to a max every day, then dropping back for some volume. It's a really, really fun way to lift. It's probably how you started out, so it's got kind of a really cool memories attached with and everything like that. And there's some people who don't want to move on from linear just because of the simplicity of how it's laid out. However, the problem with linear is once you get a little bit more advanced and either you learn the movement patterns really well or you get a little bit too strong, then linear stops working. So although I've been fighting against it very, very hard, there's so many people who want this next step past basic linear. And all they're going to be doing is trying to stretch out the progression and making it a little bit easier and playing with a little bit so you will continue to progress for longer with it. Now, what I thought I'd do for this particular programming video is start laying out some of the basic tenets of it, but I did write out a full day that I'm gonna get into pretty quickly here so you guys can have some idea if this is even worth you guys get into. If this is something you're interested in doing, then keep listening. If you're not, you can get out of here. All right, so real quick breakdown, basic stuff here. This is gonna be a 16-week program. It's stretched out longer because we can't make the jumps quite as big because we're doing something like a linear program. So the jumps need to be smaller, it needs to take longer. This is gonna be a marathon. It's not about getting as much strength as fast as possible. This is about making a good progress for a long period of time. So that's why we stretched it out 16 weeks, but that means that you have four different 4-week waves, okay? So basically, each month is going to be one of your waves. Now, each one of those waves is going to have a certain focus. You're gonna start out your first week 1, 2, 3, 4, so your entire first month, your first wave is gonna be light. Your second 4 weeks are gonna be medium, your third 4 weeks are gonna be heavy, your final 4 weeks are gonna be testing, okay? So everything's gonna get progressively heavier. Now each week of that 4-week wave is gonna be split up into four separate workouts based off of the four big movements. Your deadlift, your bench, your squat, and your overhead press. What order you stick them in is up to you and what kind of your goals for your training personally are. But that's what I'm lining up for this one. Now also each day is going to have a separate focus as well. So your first day is gonna be a testing day, your second day is gonna be a heavy day, third day is gonna be a medium day, fourth day is gonna be a light day, and those things are gonna rotate so that in any given week, you're not doing testing, 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 or heavy, heavy. You're gonna be able to vacillate those weights so you're not always going in and just always going heavy or always going light or always going medium. It's gonna vacillate throughout the week so that you're always getting different type of stimulus and you don't get too burnt out at any given time. So that breaks down to four workouts a week, and I have this planned out with giant sets, so it should only take you about an hour and 15 minutes to an hour and a half per workout. If you do not do this giant sets, then it's probably gonna take you the remainder of your adult life. There's a lot going on. Okay, so now here's a closer look up of your very first wave. Your first wave, like I said, is gonna be light. After that, your next four is gonna be medium, then heavy, then testing. So we progressively build tolerance, you build strength, everything goes up. Once you test, you get new one rep maximums, you start back over at the light with higher one maximum, it all works out, okay? So, like I said, you've got your four basic exercises, which each day is based off of, but each day, like I said earlier, the way that I like to run linear is that I come in and I go for a certain rep max. So my very first day, like I said, each day is going to have a certain focus. My first focus is gonna be my testing, next day is gonna be heavy, next day is medium, next day is light. Come back again the next week is gonna be heavy, next week's gonna be medium and light. So as you can see, I won't go super heavy again on my deadlift for another month. So I go heavy one time a month and then that progressive gets lighter before we come back up and get heavier again. And that's how it kind of rotates all the way around. As you guys can see, it kind of collapses on itself so that you're never really doing too much of the same thing every single week. So you shouldn't get too beat up from this. And that is why this is gonna be a next level type of linear as opposed to just going in and doing 10x3, 5x5, 4x8, whatever you're gonna do, because that's quickly gonna burn you out. Now, why I actually find this fun and why these numbers are up here is because this is what you're gonna be going for every day. For your first month, your first day on your deadlift, you're testing, you're trying to go for a 4 rep max, trying to get as heavy as possible for those 4 reps. The next day, you're gonna be doing your bench, heavy, you're trying to get a 6 rep max. The next day, you're doing squat, medium, 8. Next day is overhead, you're going light with 10 rep max. Come back the next week, going for a 6, then an 8, then a 10, then a 4. You guys get the idea here. So let me show you how that works in a sample training session. All right, so each individual training session is gonna be broken up into four different parts. The first of which is going to be a strength giant set. Again, you do not need to do this in giant set format, but if you don't, it's gonna take you considerably longer and you're not gonna get nearly the athletic benefits. So I would highly encourage that you think about that before you make that decision. But for today, we're just gonna use a bench day because everyone loves bench, so it's an easy example, all right? I'm gonna start out with an antagonistic muscle mover for the bench. The bench is what the day is built around. Now, guys, for me personally, since my sport of strongman has a lot of variation in it, we typically don't just do a standard deadlift, so each one of my different things, other than my testing day, if it's my heavy day for deadlift, I'm probably doing a variation. On my medium, probably doing a variation. Light, probably some sort of variation, but my testing, I'm always gonna stick to the traditional competition deadlift. Now, if you're more like a powerlifter and you need much more specificity in your training, then I would highly recommend that you actually just stick to the actual movements. However, when I'm giving this example, that's why you're gonna see so much randomness, is because I get bored with the squat, the bench, the deadlift, and I like to do different variations. So, if you guys know anything about me and doing giant sets, I always start out with the antagonistic mover before the main mover or an explosive movement. So, on my upper body days, like this day, the bench day, I start out in the same plane. I will be doing my rows before my floor press. If it was a lower body day, I'd be doing something explosive here to get my hips moving as quickly as possible. So it might be like a box jump or a burpee lateral jump or a kettlebell swing or a dumbbell deadlift that would go into like a deadlift, something like that, okay? But just for basic example, we're gonna keep it to the bench. So I do my six bent over rows to six floor presses. Now, this number right here, so this is gonna be day two since it's our bench. If we look here, day two of your first week is going to be heavy, all right? So you're going for a six rep max, just like we wrote it right here. Six, you're going for a six rep max. Now you have 30 minutes to get up there. If it doesn't take you 30 minutes, don't worry about it, but do not let it take you much longer than 30 minutes, otherwise this is gonna run too long. So 30 minutes to get up to a six rep max floor press. Now, if you guys do a personalized program with me, I almost always stick some sort of goal for you. So if you're going for a six rep max, you're probably looking at somewhere around 75%. If you can beat that, great. But if you're looking for a number to try to get to, 75% is about where you're gonna get for six. After that, I move on to a core or an oblique variation. So I'm doing eight plate halos each side and then some sort of cardio movement where I'm doing a 50 foot sled push and then I'm taking 92 2 minutes of rest and then going right back up to the top for my next attempt, all right? I don't care if you take 100 attempts. I don't care if you take 5 attempts. Whatever it takes you to get up there, just try not to take more than 30 minutes. But once you find your six rep max for the day, that is really, really awesome. Now you need to move on to your volume work, right? Because you don't really get too much stronger when you're actually testing. You get stronger from doing volume. So what I've basically broken down is a couple different volume type of prescriptions here. Now, this is the exact same thing that was just up here before for your leg week. Here's your deadlift, your squat, or deadlift, your bench, your squat, your overhead press. With your testing day, your heavy day, your medium day, your light day, it's the exact same thing that was just up here. I just made it bigger so you could see. So, once you find whatever rep max for that day is, whatever your top set was, you're gonna pull your percentages off of that. So, if it is a heavy day, because we're on this bench day, remember this is heavy day, we went for a six rep max, now on your volume is going to be heavy. Your volume is going to be 75% of your top set. So, here are the volume prescriptions. You have light at 65%, medium at 70%, heavy at 75%, and testing at 80%. But again, this is of your top set. It is not of your one rep max. See, not one rep max. So let's say you did 100 pounds for six on the floor press, and since today is a heavy day on the bench, you look down and you say heavy means that I have 75% of my top set. So I did 100 pounds for six. That means I'm gonna multiply it. Heavy, 0.75, means I go on 75 pounds for these sets. That's it. Again, not of your one rep maximum, of your top set. Now, how many reps you need to do comes over here on the side. So for your light, you're looking at 24 total reps at 65%. Medium, you're looking at 21 total reps at 70. Heavy is 18 total reps at 75. And if you're on your testing week, then you have 15 total reps at 18%. Again, not of your one rep max, of your top set. Now, whatever reps and sets you choose to get to there, I don't care. If this feels like a light weight to you and you wanna go as many reps as possible and knock out 10 reps on your first one, 8 reps on your second, 6, do whatever you need to do to get 24 total perfect reps. Some people do much better if they set up individually each and every single time. If you wanna do 24 singles, do 24 singles. If you wanna knock out all 24 at once and you can do that, then you go ahead and you do that. You do whatever it is that's gonna work out best for you. If you're a strong man, I would highly recommend you do a lot of reps, as many reps as possible, because that's what you're gonna be tested on. If you're a power lifter and you're doing the deadlift, I'd be much more likely to do a lot more singles because that's what you're gonna be tested on. So once you get down your giant set and you find that top set, you just pull your percentages off of the volume for whatever the prescription for the day was, and that's all your volume work. And again, you're just getting a total number of reps and sets, and you can do whatever you want here. You do what's best for you, and you get a little bit of more doing something that you wanna do as opposed to just lining up with like 5 sets of 5 or 10 sets of 3 or whatever the case may be. All right, so moving on, the third part of your workout is going to be some sort of assistance work. Now, I'm throwing it in a giant set format, and for me, most of my assistance work ends up going in kind of an assistance finisher type of format. I play around with the clock. I do a lot of different things to make it more interesting because I've already done a lot of just straight reps of stuff here, like floor presses and doing a lot of volume stuff. So at this point, I'm gonna wanna get a little bit more interesting, because if you tell me to do 10 sets of 3 here, I'm probably not gonna do it. But basic idea here is I'm still trying to work on the weak points of my main lift. So for this, for a floor press or any type of bench press, I'm gonna need a bigger, stronger upper back. So I'm doing some inverted rows or some barbell rows if you're strong enough. Then I'm gonna go to 30 seconds of JM presses to work my triceps and my bench. Then I'm gonna go to 30 seconds of dips and then take 30 seconds of rest or go into 30 seconds of plank or something like that. But I will do that entire thing 5 rounds or 10 total minutes. I try to keep my assistance to no longer than 10 minutes because if it gets longer than that, I tend not to do it. So whatever you choose to do here, if you wanna line up and do straight sets, 3 sets of 10 and be like big but boring, then you go ahead and do that. If you wanna play around with it, go ahead and do that. I have tons of examples of how to do this on my website, neversate.com. So if you guys need some ideas, definitely go to that. But whatever you wanna do here, guys, hit your assistance, make sure you're working the weak points of your main lifts, but it's gonna be different for everyone, because if you are on the bench and you have problems off your chest, it's gonna be a different assistance than if you have problems at lockout. So this is gonna have to be up to you and what you need to work on. And then finally, the fourth part of the workout is going to be your conditioning, because conditioning is super, super important for a billion reasons I've talked about before. For this particular day, we're just going every minute on the minute for 12 minutes, 5 burpees, 5 squats, 5 push-ups, 15 mountain climbers, 15 jumping jacks. Very basic body weight thing that we do at my gym pretty regularly. Definitely smokes people all the time, but it's just an easy way to finish out your day. Now, at my gym, we do conditioning first, and the basic idea there is that we prime our central nervous system. If you guys watch a fighter going out to the ring, they don't try to conserve all their energy before they go out there. They go out sweaty, they've been in the back grappling, they've been in the back hitting mitts. They got a ton of sweat going, they've blown out their first lung. Just like when you try to run a mile as fast as you can, typically that first lap or lap and a half, you're trying to regulate your breathing, it's really hard, and then you kind of fall into a pace, and then it gets better, right? You'd probably do better on that mile if you actually went and you ran one lap fast, blew out that first lung, and then tested your mile time. Same exact thing with our workouts here. Since we are athletes and we do compete a lot, we care about being able to move. We're not interested in being static and just staying in one place. So we do the conditioning first to get the priming of our central nervous system going, and that actually makes our strength go better. If you guys choose to do it last because you just want to leave it all out there, I was almost like a finisher, feel free to do that. All I'll say is do not skip your conditioning. Your heart is important, your health is important, body fat is important. Like, there are a lot of really, really important things, but the most important of all is the mindset that conditioning brings. I will talk extensively about that in so many other videos, guys, but if you are not pushing yourself hard at some point during your workout, then you're really missing out on a lot, because I don't know if you know, but time wins. Your biceps are not gonna be there a couple years, your strength's not gonna be there a couple years, so if you're not building something else, like up here, you're kind of wasting time. All right, guys, so we're almost through it. I'm gonna throw up those charts here in just a second so that hopefully it'll all make a little bit more sense, but I did wanna say, here are your 4 waves, right? Here's month 1, month 2, month 3, month 4. First month is gonna be light, second is gonna be medium, third is gonna be heavy, 4 is gonna be testing. However, your progression of your light to medium to heavy is all gonna be pretty, I would say mild, right? You're gonna go up kind of like a rep, maybe 2 reps here or there, going up in your progression, going for your maxes. But then when you get to your testing, everything's gonna get a little bit more serious for that month. Your recovery is gonna need to kick up because everything is going to get exponentially heavier and your reps are gonna drop pretty significantly, because in order to hit PRs, you need to build a certain amount of tolerance, and that tolerance will not get there without the heavy weights. If any of you have had a heavy squat in your past and then you didn't squat heavy for months, you came back to it, you will know that that squat feels exponentially heavier just because you don't have the tolerance anymore. Your body is not used to having that type of pressure. So this fourth month is all about building that tolerance, building that pressure, breaking your PRs, and then resetting to let your body heal here. So if you do this whole thing three times, that's an entire year of training, and that is gonna be your next level linear. Now, as always, at the end of these things, it is time for my shameless plug. Guys, this is what makes all of these videos possible. This is what makes all of the do or do not videos, the how to, the all of it, is because of people buying programs. If you guys don't buy programs, I don't make the videos. It just is what it is, guys. I do love to give these things out for free because when I was coming up, this did not exist. And if it did, I'd probably be a lot further than I am currently. And I do, at the end of the day, want to help people. However, eating food is important. So if you guys do want someone who's been down this road trip before, it's a lot easier to get from here to Florida if you have someone sitting in the passenger seat with a map that has made that drive 100 times. I'm your guy. If you need it, just email me at neversate@gmail.com. I send you a questionnaire, basically over a bunch of things. I tell you if you're even qualified for it or not, because guys, I don't accept money for things that I do not believe will work. And a lot of people will contact me and say, hey man, I want this in a program. And I will say, you're gonna have to get a different coach because I don't believe in any of that. And I don't think it's gonna work, and I won't stick my name on it. And I'm honestly not gonna take money to hand you something that I know isn't going to work. But once we get through the questionnaire stuff, it takes me a couple days to lay everything out, write it up, send it out to you, and you guys have a program that you can follow forever. But again, guys, if you do not have the money, do not worry about it. There are plenty of people in the world and someone's going to buy a program. Unless suddenly I stop making videos, at which time you should probably buy a program. But yeah, guys, literally thousands of people have requested a next step after my basic linear. So here you guys go. It's for free. I hope it helps you guys out. I hope all this made sense. I hope the charts make sense, but I thank you guys so much for staying with me. If you guys do need some help or you want someone who's just been there and you want the convenience of someone else setting up for you, make sure you email me at neversate@gmail.com. Otherwise, guys, I thank you so much for absolutely everything you do and all of your support, because honestly, guys, I'm dead serious. I could not do any of this without you guys. So seriously, we're in it together. I thank so much. I hope this helps you. I will catch up with you later in the week. Until I do, go out something amazing in your lives. Keep working on people. Be nice to each other. I'll see you then.